Good afternoon, all you garden ladies and gentlemen. It is a beautiful day. As everybody can see, the birds are chirping, the sky is blue, and I'm hungry for a snack. And I'm also eager to use something out of my garden. And so today, we're gonna make a smoothie for snack that's gonna use a special herb out of my garden. So we have a whole bunch of mint sprouting. You can actually see it popping up around my tub. Mint is perennial, which means it's gonna come back every year. So I'm gonna cut us a good sprig of mint here that we're gonna use in our smoothie. And I'm just using a nice clean pair of scissors for this. It's not, the stems aren't too tough. Maybe we'll cut a little bit more. All right, let's take this inside and put it in our smoothie. So the first thing that we're gonna do is get some of our ingredients ready for our smoothie. I like to add some citrus into my smoothie, like lemon or lime. So I'm gonna go ahead and cut my lime in half. And I have one of these fancy citrus presses. So I'm gonna use that, but if you don't have one of these, you can just squeeze it with your hand. Let's go ahead. And I'm just squeezing some lemon juice into my bowl. Next, we're gonna go ahead and put some frozen fruit into our blender. And you can really use any combination of fruit. Today, I'm gonna use some pineapple that came from the frozen section, and I'm also gonna use some banana that I cut up and froze myself. So really, any combination of fruit is good. I happen to love pineapple, and I'm gonna go ahead and put in, I just eyeball it. If you need to measure it, I put in about a cup total of fruit. Maybe a smidge more, I like fruit. All right, put in a little banana. All right. For our next step, we're gonna add some liquid. I love coconut water, and I happen to have some in my fridge that needs to get used up, so I'm gonna use this. You could also just use regular water, or if you have some juice that you wanna use, really any liquid will do for this. So I'm gonna go ahead and open this, and I like to add anywhere between a half a cup and a cup. So I'm gonna start with a half a cup and pour that in there. Yeah, I might put in a splash more for now, and we can always add more if it's not blending up nicely. For our next step, I'm gonna go ahead and add in that lemon juice that we squeezed earlier. That's gonna give us a little extra liquid in there. And then to make this super duper healthy, sneaky healthy, because you don't even know that you're consuming it, I'm gonna add a big handful of spinach. I'm just gonna stuff it down in there. And if at this point you're going, ew, spinach, well, I promise you, try it once and you'll realize that you can't even taste the spinach because there's so many other delicious things in there. And you'll know that you're getting a whole serving of healthy greens. And for our last step, we are going to add the super secret special ingredient, mint, that we just picked out of our garden. Now, if you don't have mint growing in your garden at home, you can use mint from the grocery store. So I'm gonna go ahead and add, I like a lot of mint, so I'm gonna go ahead and add, let's go with 5 leaves. If you don't like a lot of mint, or if you just wanna try it out and see if you like it, I would recommend adding just 1 or 2 leaves at first. All right, guys, here we go. It's time to whiz everything up together and watch it turn into a delicious smoothie. Last but not least, I am going to take my smoothie and I am going to pour it into a nice big cup to enjoy. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and let me know if you tried my green smoothie recipe.